Welcome to the Daily Reminder Network.
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. Daily Reminder, this is Keba Romani. Have you ever asked this question? Why me? Have you ever heard someone asking this question when calamity strikes and something might have happened to them, something they didn't like, something that they did not feel comfortable with? They might have lost someone, they might have lost a loved one, someone might have left them, they might have lost their jobs, their children. SubhanAllah, all kinds of calamities strike us every day. And a lot of people ask this question, why me? Have you ever asked this question? It's interesting because SubhanAllah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala addresses this issue in the Quran. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says,
إِنَّ الْإِنسَانَ خُلِقَ هَلُوعًا إِذَا مَسَّهُ الشَّرُّ جَزُوعًا وَإِذَا مَسَّهُ الْخَيْرُ مَنُوعًا إِلَّا الْمُصَلِّينَ.
Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, truly man was created very impatient, meaning when something happens to him, when something that he does not like, that is not according to his plans or her plans, they're very, very impatient. You know, like, why me? Look at the other person. You know, the other person is actually not as good as me. You know, why me? I pray, I fast, I give sadaqah, I try to be good to my parents. How come me? Look at this other person. He's not doing anything. He's actually cheating people. He's stealing. And it seems like he's having a good life. Things are fine. His family's fine. He's not losing anyone. He didn't lose his job. He's got money. Look at his house. SubhanAllah. It's very interesting. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, fretful when even touches him. You know, something happens to him, something evil, something that in his mind is evil, actually. In his conception, his perception, he thinks this is wrong for him. However, he doesn't understand that this is a test from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That in this test that he conceives to be evil, there might be some good for him. Something to bring him closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Something to make him realize or her realize a lesson in life. SubhanAllah. And niggardly when good reaches him. I mean, SubhanAllah. Look at this. Yani, we ask ourselves, why me, why me? Every time, you know, we lost our job, something happened that we considered not so good, we say, why me? What about when, you know, something good happens to us? What about the 99% of the time when nothing bad happens to us? And that's the default, brothers and sisters. We're actually, SubhanAllah, you're watching this video, you have a computer, you're breathing right now, you have your eyes, alhamdulillah, you have food, there's no war, you know, around you and so on. A lot of us, to be honest, we're living a good life. 99% of the time, everything is fine by default. So how come don't we ask ourselves the same question? Why me? Why did Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala choose me to be in peace? Why did Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala choose me to have a roof over my head? Why did Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala choose me to have this computer? Why did Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala choose me out of all the people that are blind to have eyesight? Why don't we ask this question ever? SubhanAllah. You know, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has blessed us with this test and with these good things. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will ask us about the patience that we had in this test and the patience that we had in, you know, enjoying this blessing and this ni'mah. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala makes the exception. You have to understand that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says that indeed mankind was created in this state. He was created very impatient. Well, there is a solution for this. There is something that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is telling you. Well, you're impatient. It's just the way you are. But the exception is there is an escape for this. What is it? What's the medicine for us? إِلَّا الْمُصَلِّينَ. Allahu Akbar. Who? Except those who are devoted to their prayers. Allahu Akbar. So if you want to escape this state of always saying, why me, and not be thankful and so on, pray. Why? Because when you pray, you know who is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You can't pray without knowing Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You can't perform your salah and, you know, glorify Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala without knowing Him. So when you do that, then you understand that He is the owner, Al-Malik. He is Rabb al-Alameen. And He is the one who does what He wills with His creation. And you submit. And whatever test falls upon you, you take it and you thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And whatever goodness comes to you, again, you take it and you thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allahu Akbar. Brothers, sisters, remember that the most beloved people to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala were the messengers, the prophets. And they never asked the question, why me? They went through so many difficulties. They died so you and I can have Islam. They never asked, why me? But in difficulties, in times of hardship, they said, متى نصر الله? When is the victory of Allah coming? ألا إن نصر الله قريب. Is it indeed that the victory of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is close? And let us not forget that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells in the Quran,
فَإِنَّ مَعَ الْعُسْرِ يُسْرًا إِنَّ مَعَ الْعُسْرِ يُسْرًا
Indeed, with every hardship comes relief. With every hardship comes relief. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to give us the patience to bear these difficulties, these tasks that, you know, might touch us here and there. And we need to really, really, we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to give us the ability to thank Him for all the blessings that we have the majority of our time. Jazakum Allah khair. This is Gabe Ar-Rumani for the daily reminder. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
Donate now. Go to www.thedailyreminder.org/donate and stay updated by joining our network social links.